Good morning. Before we start, just to check the audio, please reply whether I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nice. Yes, sir.
First of all, a big congratulations to you. Yesterday, the result was declared, is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So once again, congratulations to you. Now we will start.
Thank you, sir.
Now we will start our lecture. We'll continue with the design of liver. Okay, so whether the screen is visible to you now?
Yes, sir, it is.
Right. So we start again with the design of livers. In the initial slides, yesterday we had seen some introduction part of the liver, classification of livers, various examples, day-to-day life examples or engineering examples we have seen. And we also started the design of livers. Few slides actually we had seen yesterday, but now we once again start with the design of livers. As I said yesterday, the very first step in the design of liver is to do the force analysis. Now, force analysis means simply, as I said, finding out the magnitude and directions of the effort, load, and the reaction. Now, to find out these, you may have to use the equations of equilibrium or some basic fundamentals of the applied mechanics, that is statics part. But that is not difficult, it's very easy. So, we will not put much time in the discussing again the force analysis. So, that we can do very well, I know. So I'll skip that part, that is of depending on the forces in directions and magnitude. Second step is the design of liver cross section. Now what you see on the screen, the figure, this is the two-dimensional view of the liver, this one. Now it is better to explain with the help of some hand-drawn figure which is on the next slide here. Now you think that this is now a liver. Now when I say design of livers, one of the important step or important part in the design is to find the dimensions of the liver, dimensions of any component, is it? Though we have seen the definition of design having a very wide scope, right from the identification of the need up to the presentation, that is working drawing. That much wide spectrum the definition of the design word has. But when we come to design of individual component within the scope of our scores, that is design of mesh elements 1, we assume that all this earlier part, that is identification of design of need, the various synthesis part, that is arrangement of different components, all are done, and designer has some view of that end product before his eyes. So therefore, I assume that the designer has already gone through the process of identification of the need and the synthesis of various various components, so that he can imagine how the various components can be arranged, various parts are arranged so as to perform the work. Up to this, it is over. Now, next is to find the dimensions of the liver, dimensions of the product. So therefore, when I say now design of liver in this chapter, I mean that everything L is, you know, this is the entire the end product is already imagined, and according to that imagination, we already drawn some sketch of that drawing, say sketch of that product, and then we are thinking about now how to find the dimensions. Now, when we think of the calculation of dimensions, immediately the corresponding stresses, the corresponding failures, we must understand, and accordingly then we will go ahead to find the dimensions. Now, in this case, when I say design of lever as far as dimensions calculation is concerned, design of lever here, it means finding out the cross section of this arm. See, this is arm. Now, one end, there is one force here, other force you can place, let us say, suppose here somewhere, right? Suppose I place somewhere here, other force. Direction is not important at this point of time, okay? But forces are given, suppose. One force you can call it as effort, other force you can call it as the load. Let us say this is, say, some F value, suppose, right? And the distance is, say, some L2, okay? So from distance of one force up to the center of this is L1, distance of other force up to center of this is the distance L2. So in every case, we have to write the equation this way, that F into L2 will be equal to E into L1. This will be a state of equilibrium. At equilibrium stage, F into L2 will be equal to P into L1. Then only it remains in the equilibrium. So, design of lever means, as far as dimensions calculation is concerned, finding out this cross section of this lever. Length already, suppose we establish, or we already assume, depending on the statement of problem or depending on our requirement, length suppose are already found out. Depending on where you want to put this lever, how much force you can afford, what is the range of the operator force, right? Because operator force also has got some limitations, and accordingly also you have to give this length. Okay, so let us say for time being that the length are already known to us. Okay, so using this equation F into L2 is equal to P into L1, what if something is unknown, you can find out of these four numbers or four values, four unknowns, four parameters. If any one is unknown, you can find out by using this equation F into L2 is equal to P into L1. Okay. Now, you have to find out the reaction also. The reaction will be at the support. This acts as the support now. That reaction R also can be found out by using these various forces. Right? Suppose if I say that this is the direction of the reaction upward, then as per this direction of forces which are shown on the figure, R is equal to F into P. Okay, so forces are can be calculated. So forces calculation is not very important, because that can be calculated very well. Next step, as I said, is design of the or finding of the cross section. Now, cross section of the lever can be of two types. Yeah, two types. Either the lever cross section is taken as the elliptical cross section this way, or it is taken as the rectangular cross section. Generally, these two cross sections are preferred. In some cases, in very rare cases, in some of the books or in some of the extended numericals, you can also see this type of cross section. But it is very rarely using the lever. It is not using lever. In lever, these elliptical cross section and rectangular cross sections are always used. Now, finding out dimensions of the cross section, it means finding out these two dimensions. One is the width of these, and this is, say, a depth of these. These two values you have to find out. If you find out these, it means you already designed the cross section of the lever. Okay. Now, how to find out this cross section? One should now think in this way that what is the type of stress acting on this cross section? If I say that this is a support end, this fulcrum end is a support end, because why you say support? Because when you put this lever in use, there will be always one pin, just like a pin of a knuckle joint. Will always place one pin. This pin will be introduced inside this cavity, inside this hole, right? And then this pin remains stationary. So therefore, this surface acts as a support. So if I see now, what is the stresses acting? What type of stresses acting on the cross section? The answer is bending stress. Because this is as good as a cantilever sort of, is it? This is some support. This is some support.
सर
हेलो
सर
यस एक्चुअली आई डिड नॉट इवन रियलाइज व्हेन कनेक्शन वाज नो बिकम्स अनस्टेबल व्हाट वी डू नाउ मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स ऑलरेडी लेफ्ट. ओके व्हाट वी डू What shall we do?